everybody, welcome back. Today I'm going to be talking you through how I took notes at uni. So if you don't know, I've just finished, well, like 6 months ago, I just finished my degree in maths, and there aren't really that many videos on YouTube about maths at uni level. So I know quite a lot of people are curious about how to take notes for maths at uni level, because it's not really the sort of thing you can type. You want it all to be very ordered and clear, but it's all going to be handwritten. So I'm going to show you today how I wrote my notes and how I kind of managed them, my colour coding system, how I kept them all organised. Even though I'm finished uni now, and at the time that I finished, I was just kind of relieved that it was over, and I just wanted to be out of education. There is a part of me that's slowly coming out that kind of misses it, and I hate that because I know in reality how stressful studying was, but I think I miss writing notes because I love making things look pretty, I love making everything neat and organising things, filing them in the right places. And now I don't have that. I'm feeling a bit lost because I was in education for almost 18 years and that was my whole life. And now I don't know what I'm doing. It's very weird not having like a structure. I'm so used to having like my year from September to like July, June or July. I have so much freedom now and I don't know what to do with it. It's weird. Anyway, enough of that. Let's just get onto the video. So the way I took notes at uni was I used refill pads. So I'd just buy pads of paper with lines and pre-hole punched. I would just take that to the lectures and write my notes on that. And then when I got home, I would transfer them into the relevant folders. A lot of people on my course would have like a ring bound notebook for each module they took, and then they would just write their notes in that notebook. But the reason I chose to write mine on paper and then put them in a folder, like something like that, is because then I had the freedom to take pages out, rewrite them. If I'd missed a lecture, then it wouldn't matter. I could just write the notes up for that later and slot them in. Whereas if you wrote your lecture notes in a notebook and you'd missed the lecture, you'd have to leave a gap, kind of guessing the size of the gap you wanted to leave for that lecture you missed. And then either there would be too much content to fit in the gap and it would get really tiny and scrawny and messy, or you would fill it up and there would be a gap left. And both of those things, like, they're not a big thing necessarily, but for me, I like my notes to be clear, neat, look pretty. So I decided that that wasn't the method for me and that I'd prefer to have a refill pad, being able to tear out pieces of paper, rewrite things if they didn't look nice, slot in extra pieces of paper for things that I'd missed. It just gives me a lot more freedom. So I haven't actually looked at these since I did my exam, so this is gonna be a bit of a sort of rewind for me. But these are my previous four modules for my last semester at uni. Let's see if I can remember these. This was Hilbert Spaces. This was statistical methods. That was French. And then this would have been integral transform methods. Oh no, that's stats. So that's integrals. Forgetful. What I would usually do is print out a little label to stick on here with the name of the module so that I wouldn't get confused like I just did. By the time I got to my last term, I just had a lot on my plate and I just didn't get around to doing it. I don't know if you can see, but the spine on all these folders are completely knackered because I've put a new label on each term for each different semester that I did, because I just reused these folders. What I actually did was, at the end of a semester, once I was done with the notes, I'd transfer all of them into like one big leverage file like this. These are literally just printed on a piece of pink paper in a sort of pretty font, so they look a bit nice, and then I just literally use sticky tape to stick them on. So we'll get to those again in a second. As you may have noticed, I did take a French module last semester, which I really liked doing French. But obviously notes for French and notes for maths are very different, so I'm not going to talk about this because it's not my usual kind of method for writing notes. You got things like a lot of sort of printout sheets and worksheets and typed things. I had typed things. It's like being at school, like there's my time. Maybe one day I'll talk a bit more about how I'm learning French, because I'm still doing that. And I do have a really pretty notebook with all my French like grammar and vocab in. So maybe one day I'll show you that. But for now, let's put this over there. We'll ignore it. I can only assume that all maths courses are the same, because I don't think maths lecturers tend to have much imagination. Usually a maths lecturer has like a giant PDF document with all their notes typed up, and then in the lectures they kind of just write them on the blackboard and maybe explain a little bit. For a lecture, what I would tend to do is I would take my refill pad, I would take my pencil case, which is in here, so I'd have my calculator, which I've literally had since year 7, it's still going strong. I've had this for so long that all the numbers had rubbed off and I could still use it, like I knew where the numbers were, so I just could do it anyway without looking. But because of exams, I thought I didn't want to take that risk and accidentally press all the wrong buttons, so I stuck stickers on for that. But before that, they were just blank number buttons. This calculator has seen me through so much. My GCSEs, my A-levels, my university, and the battery hasn't died yet. It's amazing. Then I've got this pencil case. I can't guarantee that it's still, yeah, it's about the same as what it was when I was at uni. These are my preferred pens, or at least they were for third year. They're the Bic round stick M in blue. I bought a big multi-pack of these and I really like them. They write really well. A pen is a pen, really. I just liked them all to be consistent, so that's why I just used these ones. The next most important thing for my notes is this pen. This is also, I think, a Bic pen. It's one of the ones with the four colours, so we've got purple, pink, blue and green. And I have had this, I think, since college and it's still going strong. I use it for everything. Sometimes I write whole pages in a certain colour, but for the most part, I use these four colours for underlining things, writing headings. I'll come on to that a bit more in a little bit because I have a colour scheme. I think it works really well for me, so I want to talk about that in a bit more detail. On the subject of underlining things, I also have a ruler. Don't think I ever use this as an actual like measuring tool, because who would? But it's for underlining things. Sometimes I'd use a protractor or a set square, whatever there was, until I lost one or it snapped and then I would just find something else. I have a mechanical pencil and a rubber. I would very rarely use a pencil to write in the thing. Sometimes if I was drawing a graph or something, I would use it, but most of all I would use the pencil to write a little asterisk in the margin if there was something that I didn't finish writing down in time before the lecturer wiped it off the board, because they write so fast somehow. And then later on, when I had some time, I would go through my notes and fill in all the gaps from the lecture notes online. I have some post-it notes. These are the big rectangular ones. I've also got some tiny little sort of memo ones, so if there was again something that I'd missed, I might put one of those in there, or something that I needed to learn or look over or try and understand a bit more, maybe I would put one of those in to be like, look at this. And these I would use for all sorts of things, really, at the beginning of a semester when you're starting new modules and they were giving you all the sort of information about when assignments were due, the lecturer's email, stuff like that. I might write those on this, and then like I've done here, I'd stick it on the inside cover, and I would use some pretty washi tape as well, because why not. These also come in really handy when lecturers are working from printouts of lecture slides rather than handwriting things on the board. I personally am not a fan of that. I find it a lot more helpful to write things out myself, because that makes it go into my brain. But sometimes they give out lecture slides and you can kind of annotate them, and sometimes there's not enough space. In that case, I would write the annotations or like an extra proof or an example on these and kind of stick them around where the slides are on the paper. I'm not really a fan of that method, but when that's how the lecturer is lecturing, it's kind of hard to write your own notes from lecture slides like that, especially for maths when there are so many symbols and different little Greek letters which all look the same to me. I also had some Tippex, because you never know when you're gonna need Tippex, especially when you're doing loads of little fiddly things with like epsilons and etas and thetas and zetas. You can get confused very easily, so Tippex is always useful to have on hand, and I personally like would love to have enough time to be able to rewrite everything so there are no mistakes, because Tippex is not the same colour as paper and it bugs me. But I don't have infinite time, and when you're doing a degree, time is very precious, so Tippex it is. Finally, this is probably my favourite ever stationery discovery. These pastel highlighters have changed my life. These are the Stabilo highlighters in their kind of pastel range. They do a pack of four, which is blue, pink, green and purple, and then they also do a pack of six where you also get the orange and the yellow. Unless you need six colours, go for the pack of four, because these two don't look as nice, but I wanted all six, so I got all six. I have to thank Juliet, because she got me hooked on them and I love them. So that's my stationery. I would take that pencil case with all of that, my calculator and my refill pad. If there were any printed lecture notes, I would sometimes bring those as well, depending on how much space I had in my bag. It depends on the lecture style and everything, but quite often what happens is there's like a really important thing you need to write down, like a theorem, and they skip through it really fast and you're trying to write but you just can't keep up and it goes off the board, and then the lecturer spends like 20 minutes going through like some trivial proof or something that's not examinable. I hate when they spend so long going through non-examinable things, but what I would do in that time instead of listening would be to like catch up on any notes that I missed, because I mean that seemed to happen quite often, so it saved me a lot of time. Other note-taking options, like I said, a lot of people would have one notebook for each subject. Others would have one sort of project, what they call project notebooks, where it's one notebook but they've got sort of dividers between each thing. Some people somehow use their laptops. I don't know what they were, how they were taking notes, because you can't really write maths, you can't type math, like that's just not possible, especially in a fast-paced environment like in a lecture. So maybe they were just sort of reading along with the lecture notes, I don't know. And some people would have a tablet and they would write their notes by hand but on their tablet. That looked really cool. It would be nice to have no paper clutter, but I think personally this note-taking method is probably the best thing for me. I want to go through my colour scheme because I love my colour scheme, I share it with everyone. So these are my Hilbert Spaces notes from
last semester. First bit on the inside cover of the folder, I have any important things. So this is my assignment due date and the class test date. Each of the chapter names I write in blue, and then for each subchapter, I would underline that in pink. So I knew when we would be starting a new topic or a new subtopic. And then if there was a subtopic, I would underline that with one single blue line. To me, this all makes complete sense. To you, you might just be thinking like, what? Like, they're just lines, doesn't matter. But to me, it was very clear. For a definition, I would write DEF at the beginning and underline that. Then I would write the definition and either highlight or underline in green the important parts, the bits that I needed to remember. Theorems, lemmas, corollaries, that kind of thing. I would write theorem, lemma, corollary, underline that in blue, then highlight in blue any kind of formula or anything that I would need to remember. If there was like a really important statement or something that I knew would have to be embedded in my brain for the exam, that would get highlighted in pink because, you know, I love pink, so anything with pink would just stand out to me. So that was my kind of mind game I was playing on myself. Finally, I'd underline any examples with purple because purple was my least favourite colour on that big pen. It was too dark, it was too similar to the colour of my actual writing pen, so I didn't really like it that much. I only used it on examples. The yellow and the orange highlighter, like I said, I wasn't really as keen on them, so I didn't really use them as like a standard colour. They didn't really mean anything necessarily because I didn't really like how they looked, because they weren't as pastel as the other four colours, and to me that mattered. If there were an algorithm I had to know, or when I was doing graph theory, I think I did sort of the graphs in yellow and orange sometimes, they were just there as like extra colours if I needed them really. Once I've got all my notes, so these are all the things that I would like write in lectures, and that would be everything that was kind of examinable. Everything I would need to know for the exam would kind of at this point be highlighted or underlined, so I could easily pick out the points. I've also got a divider here. This side of the divider, any exercise sheets, coursework, tutorial work would all go in here. So kind of more like practice questions and stuff like that. None of this stuff looks anywhere near as pretty. It's all messy. Things are scribbled out. It's me actually doing work rather than just writing notes. So it's, as you would expect, it's a lot messier. This side's more for reference and this side is more for practice and actual understanding, if that makes sense. So those are my notes. That's kind of my method of how I would take notes. In terms of like questions to do at my uni and on my course, we would be set like a weekly set of exercises to do that weren't marked, they weren't worth anything, but we would go through them in tutorials and then it would help us to kind of understand the content and maybe give us a hint of what kind of stuff would be examinable, how questions would be phrased on the exam, stuff like that. Doing more kind of active studying, which actually engages your brain, is definitely more effective, and I do know that, but sometimes, you know, you just kind of got to prioritize. If you've got like a deadline for something which is actually being marked, that takes priority over something which isn't being marked. You just kind of got to juggle things. So some weeks I would do it myself, some weeks I would do it in the tutorial, but I tried at least to do every single sheet that was set, every single question that we were given as an example or to try at home. I tried to do, because usually if a lecturer is giving you those kinds of questions, it's because you're going to need to know them. Just to kind of compare, these are my notes for statistical methods, and this lecturer did lectures with lecture slides, and we had a printout of the slide, which I think probably be in here somewhere. Sometimes I've annotated and highlighted them, most of the time I haven't, because I actually, in the end, found it was so much easier to write them out myself. Having things in my own writing, my own kind of colour scheme and order to things, that really helped me learn things a lot better than annotating lecture slides and filling in gaps and stuff like that. So that is an example of one where I had more of a lecture slide based lecturer, and honestly I do understand why he would want to do it on a PowerPoint presentation, because some of these distributions and residual things for stats are just, they're messy, so you don't want to be writing those on the board and then getting symbols wrong and stuff. So I get it, but yeah, I prefer to write them out. It obviously completely depends on you and what sort of learner you are, whether you find it more effective to write notes or whether you find it more effective to do examples, whether you prefer paper notes or digital notes. All of those things are factors that you should consider before you decide on like your note-taking style, because I mean, at least for me, I like to have it all consistent. So I have done the same method since first year, where each one of these ring binder folders had a different subject in, and then I would transfer them at the end of the semester. And that worked for me all the way through. I kind of adapted things as I needed to. I liked that all my notes were the same style. I could reference them all in my big LibreArch files, which I will actually show you just now. First up, I kept all my A-level notes in one. This folder I think was from Sainsbury's, it's really pretty. Each booklet for each module I did at A-level is just about crammed in there, and that was really useful to be able to reference things, like simple things that you should be able to do, especially at
university level, but sometimes your mind goes blank and you're like, wait, hang on, how do you differentiate cos?
This folder is also from Sainsbury's. This is first year calculus and linear algebra. I would always keep all the handwritten notes that I'd done, so the bit that was before the divider in all my folders, that would always stay. And then it would depend on the module whether I kept things like example questions or like notes I'd done before the exam, where I usually had sort of an info sheet of everything I would need to remember. Sometimes I would keep that. Really, it depended on whether I was doing like a follow-on module. So like, for example, these are all my notes for Linear Algebra 1, and then I also kept all the questions and exercise sheets for that too, because next semester I was doing Linear Algebra 2. So being able to go back and look at the actual method that I used to do the questions was really helpful in that case. But sometimes I would do a kind of standalone module which I knew I was never going to have to use again. For example, in first year there was a compulsory mathematical modelling which was kind of like mechanics and physics. That is not my thing. I knew I would never voluntarily choose to do that again. After first year you can kind of choose all your own modules, so I knew that it was very unlikely that I would ever need to look back at those. I haven't looked back at them at all, so I definitely didn't need to keep all the questions and stuff, which is great. But really I tried to cull things as much as possible, because you can get through a lot of paper in one module. Like even just in exams, I got through 2 refill pads in my previous exam period, which is why I don't have any more refill pads here, because I thought there wasn't any point in buying another one, so I was literally just using any scrap paper I could to do exam questions. Backs of receipts and everything was crazy. So there how I kind of store my notes, and then like I said, you've got a nice pretty label on each one. They all go stacked in my bookshelf next to each other. I've got all my second year notes in here. I try to group things together as much as possible. Algorithms, PDEs, stats methods, stats distribution, they're all in there. And then my pure modules are in a separate one, because I knew that pure was what I was interested in, so for those I kept them in a bit more detail and I kept them all together, because I knew I'd be referencing those ones the most. Then also in here are my third year first semester modules, because they just slotted it in and they were kind of all more pure things. I just like to keep things easily accessible and also kind of easy to find, so everything's labelled, everything's neat, organised, put in with dividers with labels on, beautiful. And having all my notes ready to reference if I needed them did come in really useful, because the further I got in my degree the more sort of specific my modules were, but they were relying on all the knowledge from my previous years. So especially things like my first year calculus folder, those things were coming up all the time, so if there was something I needed to go back over, I could easily just pull out one of these folders, flick to the bit that I needed, and it would all already be beautifully highlighted, so I knew exactly what I was looking at. And that's actually another benefit, at least I think, of writing on paper instead of in books, because then I can transfer just the things I want to keep. I think that is everything I have to tell you about how I took notes for uni. I got a bit carried away. I get very excited about talking about stationery and organisation, and also I don't talk about maths much, especially now that I'm not surrounded by people who maths. Like, I don't have maths friends anymore. I mean, I do, but I don't see them every day, so I think I just kind of like verbal vomited everywhere. Sorry. Looking through those has actually made me really miss studying at uni, which I never thought I would say, and not even just like the fun side of it. Like, I look at the maths and I'm like, yeah, I remember doing that, what a great time. So it's confirmed, I am officially like officially a nerd. If there are any more uni related or maths related videos you would like me to make, please just let me know. I know I'm not at uni anymore, but I'm just clinging on to the fact that I was a student at some point, so uni content, I'm gonna still make it, I don't care. Okay, hopefully you found this video useful, or maybe enjoyed it, just like being a bit nosy. That's what I would be like. If you're not subscribed, then please do, because I'm like so close to 10,000 subscribers. I think I'm about 150 away, and 10,000 just sounds like a legit number, so it would mean a lot to me if you would subscribe. I promise I'll make more videos like this. If that's what you want, just let me know. And yeah, thank you for watching, and I will see you very soon.